Microsoft Loop has been around for a few years now, and it's Microsoft's way for you to collaborate in one location. And if you're using Microsoft 365 for your team, then it's something that you may want to switch on and unlock as part of your package. I'm going to dive into the workspaces, pages, components, and make it as simple as possible for you to know and understand Microsoft Loop. So I think the first port of call is to understand what Microsoft Loop really is. Well, it's very simply like a page, a documents experience, but it also has real-time collaboration, meaning you and your team can collaborate in real time on it, and also ways to bring in documents, files from other Microsoft 365 experiences that you're using. There's also a superpower in it called Loop Components, and you can imagine how useful this is in meetings, but it's simply the idea that you can take a component from a page like a table and be able to still collaborate on it in real time whilst in other apps like Microsoft Teams or OneNote or any of the Microsoft ecosystem apps. So the best way to describe Microsoft Loop is a collaborative workspace for your team. I think the best start is to dive into the app and explore some of the features in a bit more detail. So this right here is Microsoft Loop. Now it comes on a few different devices, Android, iOS, and also on Windows and Mac. Now the application itself is a documents type experience, and this is what you'll land on when you create a Loop account. So I think the best thing to do is jump into Loop and see what and how it works. So this is what Microsoft Loop looks like. And it is, like I said, a document to start things out with. And you can create a workspace where you can bring in documents, files from other apps in Microsoft 365, all into this one location. So it's an aim to be a collaborative environment for you and your team. So think if you're planning a launch or something, you want to be able to bring in the drive file with the brand assets, or maybe even you want to bring in some Excel spreadsheets or other Word documents, and then be able to collaborate on a table or whatever to bring the project together. That can all be done in here. So to start out, you can give everything a title. And as you can see, this is how it appears. So you can also add an icon, much like you can with other popular apps like Notion and even other internal wiki apps. You can also add a cover to it and choose from a range of different options. And as you can see, it already gives a page some detail and some more information. Now over here, down at the bottom, you can see that there's a template gallery. Now this is gonna save you a bunch of time if you're looking to just create that structure that you might need. And there's about 20 or so different templates that you can choose from. So I'm not going to use a template. I'm going to start from blank. And what I'm gonna press is the slash command. Now inside of Microsoft Loop, if you press the slash command, you can essentially see all the regular stuff you get in a text formatter. But there's also additional abilities like table of contents, new subpage, and even some templates that you can build within the document. So here's a good template that you can use, like a task list for organizing what the project is working on. And you can see here that it creates that list and allows you to start building it out. Now, obviously this is in line, so you can still start wording the document and using Markdown to create different sections, and you can start using that down there. But I just want to go back to what the component looks like. And this is where that special power comes in. So you can organize these in a board view or even a table view. And there's a few different ways that you can set up rules, columns, stuff that you'd expect from a table like this, with filtering and sorting as well. Now, if you were using this as a task list, you could do and assign it to other people. For example, here we go. And you can also give due dates and things like that. And this would all turn out inside of your notifications area. But most importantly, this can be turned into something called a loop component. Now, loop components essentially live in Microsoft Loop, but can be used anywhere. So if I create this loop component, it does this little sort of thing. And basically what you can do here is then collaborate on it in another application. So you're probably wondering, what does this look like? Well, in an example we're gonna show on screen, there is the Microsoft Teams example where you can actually edit it when you're in Microsoft Teams. Multiple people can collaborate on it. But what it looks like from any of the central ends is this. So for example, this is somebody else editing. It's actually me, I'll give you a clue, and you can use it and see it in real time. So folks, if you're interested in getting 3 new tools in your inbox every single week, I'm gonna send them to you. And they're ones that I think are new and noteworthy. So if you're interested in that, you can sign up to the newsletter below and discover 3 new tools every week. on with the video. So that's one of the benefits of using the pages in Loop, is that everything is real time and collaborative. And you can also see, copy that component wherever it may be in Microsoft Teams. And you can also see the shared locations that it lives in. So once you know that this is a live component, a Loop component, you can then get an idea of where it's being used and where it's being activated. It can even take you to that exact location. So you can also see and choose who has access to it as well, which is a helpful way to break things down. And other people can still add all the relevant stuff as long as they have access. So Loop components can be used with any of the tables or the different setups in here. So you can even create a mini template for yourself. For example, there is other templates like a progress tracker, Kanban board, and things like that. They can all be used in a Loop component and turned into a Loop component, a really useful way to collaborate. So how can this be used in practicality? For example, if you're in a Teams meeting and you're using Teams chat on the side, you could all collaborate in real time or asynchronously to build up an idea of a plan and be able to collaborate and see other people being able to assign stuff to you and move workload around. And that could be a really helpful way to not just work hybrid, but also asynchronously. So up at the top of the page, you may be able to see that this indicates how many and what types of people are using the application. This is a great way to see stuff and make sure that you're giving access to the right people. Up here, you can share just the workspace, the page link, or the Loop component that turns it into a collaborative workspace. You can also rename, restyle, see version history, and use some of the AI features. Now, I think this is probably a great time to mention some of the AI features. There are some cool abilities, which I'll show you on screen, in which you can use AI Copilot alongside it. This will help you to form up your documents, improve the writing and grammar, but it also helps you to do generative AI in general, which is a helpful feature. There's also something called Recap. Now, Recap is a feature where it gives you summaries of the changes that have been made, and this is really helpful because you can mention people when changes have been made. So you can almost leave these notes of things that have happened whilst your document has been in action. So for example, if you're working asynchronously or the other person's not working on the same project as you at the same time, I could create a recap and just say, you know, Bob, what changes? Summarize the changes there. So this can be a great way to leave a few notes for other people that may be starting a document and just seeing what's been made. So otherwise, there are a few different things that you can use on this side here. You can search across all of your components and your pages as part of your Microsoft Loop account. But you can also use something called ideas. Ideas, sort of like a draft, and that's essentially what they are. You can create them as a page, and then you can be able to modify them in your own private manner without sharing them with other people, which is a great way to soft launch an idea and then be able to use it and launch it to your Microsoft Loop team, and collaboration can begin. So here's what the workspace looks like. And from here, you can see any recent components, ideas, and workspaces that you're part of. And up here in the corner, you can change a few of the settings like the accessibility, languages, and Microsoft Editor, which is built in to make sure that you can improve your text predictions and your proofing. So that's a very basic overview of Microsoft Loop, but it's incredible way as a team to collaborate on ideas and thoughts. Please do let me know if you have any questions about it in the link in the description. I look forward to seeing whether Microsoft Loop can be a part of your team. If you're already using it or maybe toying with the idea, share your thoughts below and it'd be great to hear about it. And also, if you found this useful, do like it because it shares it beyond your community and helps other people to discover it on YouTube. So thank you very much. I look forward to helping you in more videos. Do subscribe and I will see you very soon. Cheerio for now.